Hello students, from this video we will start unit 3. In unit 2 we have seen about how criminals plan cyber offenses against individual or against an organization. We also learnt about how mobile technology plays an important role to launch a cyber attacks. With this background, in unit 3 we will focus on different forms of attacks through which attacker targets the computer system. These are various tools. There are various tools and techniques and complex methodologies used to launch attacks against the target. Network attack incidents reveal that attackers are often very systematic in launching their attacks. The basic stages of an attack we will see here to understand how attacker can attack on the network. The first stage is initial uncovering. The second stage is network probe. Third one is crossing the line toward e-crime. Fourth is capturing the network. Fifth, grab the data. And last one is covering the tracks. The first stage is initial uncovering. It involves two steps. The first step is reconnaissance. It means the attacker gather the information. And attacker gather the information by searching the information about target on internet, by googling the social networking websites like Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, if target is a particular person. If the target is company or organization, the information is gathered by surfing the public websites or searching news articles and press releases about that organization. In the second step, the attacker uncovers or discovers as much information as possible on the company's internal network, such as internet domain, machine names, and company's internet protocol addresses, that is IP addresses ranges of that organization. As this is the early stage, it is not possible to detect the attacker because they have not done anything illegal activity. These kind of information requests are considered as a legitimate and authorized one. The next stage is network probe. At this stage, the attacker uses a more invasive techniques to scan the information. Here, usually ping sweep of a network IP addresses is performed to seek out potential targets or ally hosts on particular network. Then port scanning tool is used to discover exactly which services are running on the target system. At this point, the attacker has still not done anything that would be considered as an abnormal activity or illegal activity on the network. The next stage is crossing the line toward the electronic crime or a e-crime. In this stage, attacker is going to commit a computer crime and he or she does this by exploiting or by utilizing the possible holes or vulnerabilities on the targeted system. The easiest way is to gain entry is check the user accounts with easily guessable passwords. Once attacker are able to access a user account without many privileges, they will attempt to exploit the root access. What is root access? It is basically an administrator or a super user access and grants them the privileges to do anything on the system. Using this, they will cross the line by doing a e-crime. The next stage is capturing the network. At this stage, the attacker attempts to own the network. It means he or she will take the control of the whole network. The attacker easily and quickly enters into internal network by compromising low priority target systems. After this, the next step is to remove any evidence of the attack. The next step is to remove any evidences of the attack. Then the attacker usually install a set of tools that replace the existing files and services with the Trojan horse files. There are number of hacking tools which can be clean up log files and remove any trace of intrusion, means attack. Most of the time, these are the programs written by the hackers. Most of the time, these kind of hacking tools which are used to clean up the log files and removing a history, those are the programs specially written by the hackers. And such tools provide the copies of the system files that look and act like a real one, but they provide the attacker a backdoor entry or unauthorized entry into a system and hide the process the attacker might be running on that system and user information also. Now we can call as a attacker has captured the network. Once attacker has gained access to system, he or she repeat the process until his intention to be cleared. The next step is grab the data. Now attacker has captured the network and he or she takes advantage of his or her position to steal the confidential information or a credit card information. He may alter the processes on the system and he will launch the attack on other sites from your own network, causing the embarrassing situation for a person or an individual or an organization. The next step is covering the tracks. This is the last step in a cyber attack. It refers to activities undertaken by an attacker to extend the misuse of system without being detected. The attacker can remain undetected for long periods, or he or she use this place to start a fresh reconnaissance to a related target system, or a attacker may continue to use resources by removing the evidence of a hacking. During this entire process, the attacker takes care to hide his or her identity from the first step.